This indicates that the battery is exhausted. On the new Ismore Spion, the battery is very easy to replace. Screwing an antenna on is also very simple. For who wants to see the connection types, I made a close-up shot. For measuring electric fields, you always need to touch this metal connection on the side. You always touch it first before turning the device on. This device does not come with an option to do hands-free measurements. For RF, you don't need to touch the metal connection on the side. You can do hands-free measurements no problem. Never touch anything with the antennas. In the past, the old Ismore broke down by touching a faucet that had EMF on it. Stay some distance from a source. Pull the device away if the LEDs go into the red. This is a light module that can detect light flicker. There is an on-off switch. Set the Ismore Spion to NF. And then turn it in the direction of an artificial light source. If this LED does not burn when the device is on, the battery is exhausted. Very carefully open the device, else you can snap a wire that runs in the middle from one half to the other. I recommend replacing the battery while sitting on a chair over a table, exactly like was seen here. Be careful not to drop this device when doing measurements because it opens easily. This is how you set the device to do electric measurements. I extend the telescopic antenna out completely for maximum sensitivity. For electric, you must always touch the screw on the side. Always do this before you turn the device on. It's a good habit to never touch anything with an external antenna and always stay some distance from a source. I personally like to approach electric sources like demonstrated here. Now the standard setup for doing RF measurements. Adjust volume with this knob. Be careful for your ears because it can go very loud. When done, put the antenna back. This is another setup for RF measurements. This way it is extra sensitive. This is the setup for using the light sensor. Don't forget to put the switch back when done. This is the light sensor.